weekend on home ice. Back-to-back games starting tonight before a jam-packed crowd against Montreal. The Panthers roll with Roberto Luongo in net. So mathematically, pretty big matchup for December.
Yeah, they call these four-point games.
Turnover, chance in front, and the Canadiens score. Oh, Montreal gets one early from Tatar. It's 1-0.
Tatar gets he basically gets a gift, and he doesn't miss.
But poor on that shift, and it results in Montreal getting the first goal, Tatar's 13th of the year. Now the Barkov line on for the Panthers against the Domi line. This is Montreal's top line, and Jonathan Drouin puts it out in front, a chance again, and the Byron shot denied. Oh boy, Montreal with two glorious chances. The first goes in, the second came close.
Everything that happened this far doesn't matter.
Another turnover by the Panthers defense. Lekkonen centering feed, and Kotkaniemi hit the post. Oh my, that one stays out.
Montreal Canadiens bring, so the forecheck is gonna be hard to deal with.
Jay Weber up at the point. And now Matei's shot, and they score again and deflect it in. Delorier may have gotten a piece of it. Montreal's up 2-0 early.
Bounces. It's got to bounce 3 feet right here, right over the shoulder of Roberto Luongo. You don't see that hardly ever.
Here comes Hoffman through center. Petrano up in the rush with him, and Borgstrom as well. Hoffman along the wall, stolen away by Shaw. Hoffman's got it again. Backhander, Borgstrom with a chance, score! The artist paints a beauty, and the Panthers are on the board.
Watch Borgstrom. There's nobody around him. He gets himself in the open, and then he drills a cool wrister.
Got it up the wall, and Dennis Malgin fires ahead. He's got Brouwer moving in. Brouwer looking for McCann and rolls towards the net. Brouwer puts it in front. Bounces on goal, they score! Dennis Malgin has tied the game at 2.
Niemi handles everything fine, but the puck bounces off one of his own players, goes up in the air. Watch this. It goes off the skate of Biron. And that's something you see very often. Referees are good at getting out of the way.
Byron tackles Dadonov. Play rolls on. Boy, grabbed him right around the back of the head there. Here's Ben at the point. And now Ben again. Cross ice feed. Chipped in front. Luongo the save. The Panther line and shoots in. Weegar into the boards by Byron. Malgin attacks Tatar, but he finds Riley. Goes cross-ice. Kotkaniemi hit the post again. The 18-year-old has caught the iron twice already.
Tell you what, he can really move that puck. You remember earlier in the period, he was left all alone in front of the net, and he hit the post as well. Can they make the Montreal Canadiens pay?
Here's Yandel quickly set up. The blistering hot Hoffman. Down low, Barkov in front, deflected away. Oh, for a moment, Huberdeau had an open cage.
What a play by the veteran Weber.
With McCann right on the doorstep. Here's Borgstrom as the power play ends. Vetrana sends it on net. Saved by Niemi as McCann again in front. Got a stick on it.
Quick changes, stay fresh.
Shaw fires ahead. Domi with speed is in. It's a 2-on-1. Domi shoots and Luongo makes a big save.
I mean, when you talk about kind of like a ball of energy, I think he's a lot faster than people think he is, particularly the people on the ice.
Through the neutral zone that they struggled.
Now Yandel tries to do it himself here. He gets in and controls. Back it goes for McCann, sets up Hoffman, saved by Niemi. Oh, they got the look and the guy they wanted. Five on five hockey. All the goals came in the first period here. Malgin for Brouwer, saved by Niemi. On the scoreboard.
Now you know the key word between periods was tightening things up by both coaches.
Domi gets a pass in front, and Byron is stopped by Luongo. Dadonov checked. And the Canadiens have the puck. Tatar to center. Has the defenseman Riley up with him. Riley steers it towards the net, knocked down in front by Tatar to get to center. But then he lost it.
Well, those Canadians come back fast, don't they?
Tatar, centering feed. Kulak, the defenseman, puts it in front. Save Luongo on Gallagher.
That's what I mean. He's going to try and use all of his expertise, even while he's on the road, to try and get Danault against Barkov.
The Domi line on for Montreal. Domi the feed. And Luongo with a big save on Riley.
World Junior Championship.
Danny, I think I read where the Finns in the World Junior Championship, they've qualified for the medal round like 25 straight years.
Amazing.
Lekkonen in front with a shot, saved by Luongo. Rebound bouncing around, and finally Hoffman gathers it in. Gives to Matheson, one-timer save, rebound in front, swept out of the blue paint by Riley. Remember? Oh, what a chance there, and Gallagher the other way. Danault moves in. Danault for Gallagher, it hit the post. Stick checked away. And Delorier behind the net. Taken back by the Panthers, Henrik Bortstrom. Moves out of his own end to give to Vetrano. Back for Bortstrom, he's in. Bortstrom shoots, and Niemi makes the save. Vetrano couldn't handle the rebound. Bortstrom nearly had another one for Tatar. Has to play it behind him. Matheson got a piece of the puck. Tatar works it to the slot. Drouin for Domi, waiting. Hesek got a piece of it, and now Tatar scores! 5-on-4 goal for Montreal, and they lead 3-2 in the third.
The puck just seems to come to him. Look, another, you know, that puck deflects off of Pesek's skate, goes right to the Montreal Canadiens. Drouin, arguably the best passer, good thing, and made it to not an odd man rush for Montreal.
Shaw behind the net, puts it in front, and they score. Lekkonen makes it 4-2, Montreal.
Florida Panthers allow the front of the net to be unguarded, and 23-year-old Lekkonen finds himself with another goal.
21-second differential between the shot or the game clock and the penalty. Two-man advantage, Florida. Barkov controls the puck. Here's Yandel moving in, slap shot, score! With 1:16 left, the Cats are alive. It's a 4-3 game.
The power play comes through at a crucial time for the Florida Panthers.
Luongo, as they get in, will get to the bench. Dadnoff breaks in. Panther net empty again. Looking for a late finish. Huberto with a chance, he hit the post! And that's loose in front, Dadnoff couldn't stuff it in!
Florida Panthers created so many chances, the only thing they couldn't do is put...
30 seconds left. Clear to the point. And out. And now the Canadiens with an empty net. Drouin puts it away. The Panthers inches away from getting it tied, now trail 5-3.
They did it by having a really fast start in Vegas, the Stanley Cup contenders, or finalists, and they did the same thing here.